way. This was a $5,000 to win race, $1,000 to make the A-Main just to start. Some of the biggest cars and drivers from around the Midwest showed up for this. But here is the four-breast salute to the fans at the opening ceremonies for the Jayhawk Modified Classic, September 16th at Lakeside Speedway. Here is the start of the Jayhawk Modified Classic. That is Tim Carrick on the pole. That's Jason Hughes on the outside. Johnny Allen in the orange 98, and I believe it was Tom Charles was in the yellow 81. But here, Tim Carrick has jumped out to the lead with Johnny Allen in second. Jason Hughes, young man from Oklahoma, there in third place. Here Hughes gets around Johnny Allen and moves into that second spot. That is Scott Crystal there running in fourth. The red and white, number five, but that's Tim Carrick in the lead. Jason Hughes there. Here on lap 18, the black car in the lead there, is in second place. That's the Jason Hughes. And then in third place is in the orange and white 98 is Johnny Allen as they race pretty much side by side for that second place. Here Johnny Allen gets ahead of Hughes as they come out of turn four. And he takes over that second place. This race was run green flag from green to checkered. But here, Johnny Allen takes over second place from Jason Hughes. Tim Carrick still leads. As you can see, he's pulled out to just about half a straightaway lead. Here, Johnny Allen has closed down and caught up to Tim Carrick, who had a substantial lead in this race. But here, on lap number 25, as we get down to the closing stages of this race, Johnny Allen starts putting some pressure on Tim Carrick. Tim Carrick, of course, is the points champion for the year and has been in the running for the National Points Championship. Johnny Allen, of course, has been on his heels the whole time, as Johnny Allen has pretty much dominated down at Linn County. But Tim Carrick, of course, has been the points champion at Lakeside Speedway for this 2006 year. Here, Bubba Harvey in the middle of a lap car as they pass in. And as they come out of turn number two, Johnny Allen gets just a little bit of an advantage on Tim Carrick and takes over the lead here on lap number 27 of this 30-lap race. Tim Carrick, being the tough competitor that he's been all year, will show here why he is the points champion at Lakeside Speedway as he comes back and starts working on Johnny Allen to try and get this lead back. Here he pushes in on the inside of him going into turn three and gets Johnny up a little bit high. This is a white flag lap, as the fastest way around this track was right down on the bottom, because this was a very dry, slick racetrack. But here Tim Carrick takes that lead back on the white flag lap as he is going to come around and take the checkered flag for this win on September the 16th at Lakeside Speedway for the Jayhawk Modified Classic. Here's Tim as he gets out of his car after the race, after this great win. It's been a fantastic year for Tim. Here's your third place finisher. This is Jason Hughes. And like I say, he's from a little town down in Oklahoma. He's also a chassis builder. He's this orange car here. He's a chassis builder of Johnny Allen's car. It's a Hughes chassis. There's Johnny Allen, your second place finisher. Terry Watlin, flagman. And here is part of the Carrick family as they surround Tim Carrick after this big win. $5,000 payday for this Jayhawk Classic. Don't know that gentleman's name, but he represents the McCarthy Auto Group.
What do you think? You tell me what that was all about.
I don't know. Something was going on back there. I don't know whether he pushed him out or.
I used to have a lot of respect for both of these guys who just lost it all for him.
Here it is, the winner of your Jayhawk Classic, Tim Carrick.
Lace up your boots and we'll truck on down to a knocked-out shack on the edge of town. There's an 8-beat combo that just won't quit. Keep a walking till you see a blue light lit. Fall in there and we'll see some sights
down at the house, the house, the house of blue lights.
There's fryers, broilers, and Detroit and barbecue ribs. But the treat of the treat is when they serve up those fine 8-beats. You'll want to spend the rest of your